Liszt constantly revised his compositions, both before and after publication. Comparison of the various versions of his works offers wonderful glimpses into his atelier. The version of Totentanz usually played is his last revision, the only one published in his lifetime. There exists, besides numerous sketches and minor revisions, at least one other complete manuscript version of Totentanz, differing substantially from the one which Liszt published. This earlier version, which Busoni published, contains some very happy inventions not included in the final edition. Par revanche, the final version contains splendid things not in the earlier version. Overall, the final version is more complete and the piano writing more grateful. In an effort to have the best of two worlds, I thought it would be interesting to try to maintain the final version intact and at the same time to reinstate some splendid pages from the earlier version. To my pleasant surprise, I found that this could be done without even having to compose one bar of Liszt Löwenthal. The only passage I have removed from Liszt's final version is the very opening of the piece. You may remember that it begins with piano and drums thumping out the following grisly march vamp. Over that rhythm, the orchestra plays the grand old Gregorian chant, which was sung in the Mass for the Dead to the words of the Dies Irae. Now, much as my pianistic ego is loath to forego the rare pleasure of having the first word in a piano concerto, you know, the poor pianist usually has to sit shivering through a seemingly endless orchestral introduction. Nevertheless, the early version of the opening of Totentanz seems to me so wonderful that I have reinstated it, although I don't have a note to play in it. Instead of piano and drums, a solitary church bell clangs away in the distance and the Dies Irae is intoned softly. This sinister, soft opening makes the ensuing orchestral crash and wild piano cadenza sound startling enough to wake the dead, and that's just what was intended. From here on, I use Liszt's final version intact for the first two-thirds of the piece. The early version contains a slow rhapsodical section based on the psalm De Profundis, Out of the Deep I Call to Thee. I find this to be one of Liszt's most beautiful pages, and I think it is a great pity for audiences not to be able to hear this music. With scissors and paste, I have been able to rescue it from oblivion. I found it possible to take up the early version just before the De Profundis section. Here is the point where the early version enters. The De Profundis section begins with solemn trombones. The woodwinds take up the theme, and then piano and orchestra together play two wonderful variations on it. This is followed by a short, agitated orchestral tutti based on the Dies Irae. Right here, I return to the point at which I left off in Liszt's final version, a furious piano cadenza which begins. Instead of letting the orchestra enter at the end of it for the finale of the piece as given in the final version, I insert one more section from the early version. This consists of an octave flourish. Which leads directly into a contrapuntal combination of the Dies Irae and De Profundis themes, thus justifying the presence of the De Profundis in a piece made up of variations on the Dies Irae. Piano, strings, and a few other instruments play the Dies Irae down below this way. While at the same time, up above, the woodwinds and brass scream out the De Profundis. Here are the two themes combined. This brief peroration ends in an acceleration which leads smoothly back into Liszt's final version, just where I had left off. I do hope that the Löwenthal version of Totentanz has not caused Liszt to do a Grabestanz.